This is Aish Joshi, and again I'm here with you with a brand new session of this channel GYS. So first of all, I would like to welcome you. So मेरी और GYS की टीम की तरफ से आपका बहुत बहुत आभार है कि आप हमारे साथ यहाँ पर हैं. We are very thankful to you कि आप अपना precious time हमें दे रहे हैं और हमारे सारे ही important courses को consistently you are going through all these videos and all these content. Hopefully ये सारा content आपके लिए helpful है और आपके लिए कहीं ना कहीं ये matter करेगा definitely. And exam के अंदर आने वाले सारे questions को मद्देनज़र रखते हुए, या हम कह सकते हैं कि अपने सारे efforts, current affairs, examination patterns, सारे examination patterns जो हैं अभी जो हाल ही में चल रहे हैं कॉम्पिटिटिव लेवल पे, तो उन सबको ध्यान में रखते हुए हम ये सारे videos prepare कर रहे हैं, जिससे कि एक एक video आपके लिए एक अच्छा content लेकर आए. और एक वीडियो के अंदर पर्टिकुलर एक ही टॉपिक ले रहे हैं, जिससे कि आपका एक एक टॉपिक बहुत अच्छे से क्लियर हो जाए एंड इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू टू अटेम्प्ट द क्वेश्चंस. बिकॉज जब आपके एक एक कंसेप्ट क्लियर होगा, आपका एक एक पॉइंट क्लियर होगा एक पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक से रिगार्डिंग, तो डेफिनेटली आप एग्ज़ाम में उसको बहुत अच्छे से अटेंड कर सकते हैं. और मेरी कोशिश ये है और अचीव आई एस की पूरी टीम, हमारी कोशिश ये है, हमारी कोशिश रहती है कि हम सारे ही वीडियोस के अंदर एक एक टॉपिक के अंदर वो सारे पॉइंट्स कवर करें जो आपके एग्ज़ाम के अंदर आ सकते हैं. तो डेफिनेटली अगर मैं बात करूँ तो हमने एक भी पॉइंट कहीं से भी स्किप करने की कोशिश नहीं की है, और हमने कोशिश की है कि कहीं कुछ बच रहा है तो वो भी ऐड कर दिया जाए. सो डेफिनेटली इट विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू एंड उम्मीद करती हूँ कि आपको ये वीडियोस पसंद आ रहे हैं. और अगर पसंद आ रहे हैं तो गाइज प्लीज़ पुट अ लाइक और सब्सक्राइब बटन, बिकॉज ये सब्सक्राइब करना आप ही के लिए यूज़फुल है. बिकॉज अगर आप इसे सब्सक्राइब करते हैं तो आपके पास में और भी हमारे न्यू वीडियोज़, न्यू अपडेटेड वीडियोज़ आते रहेंगे, जो एटलीस्ट आपके अपकमिंग एग्ज़ाम्स के लिए इम्पॉर्टेंट है और आपके लिए यूज़फुल है. बिकॉज ये सारे वीडियोस हम बना रहे हैं करंट अफेयर्स पे. दीज ऑल दीज वीडियोस आर बेस्ड ऑन करंट अफेयर्स ओनली. सो फॉर दीज करंट अफेयर्स, फॉर दीज वीडियोस आई कैन से करंट अफेयर्स एस्पेक्ट्स आर टोटली कवर्ड इन दीज वीडियोज. सो यू शुड गो थ्रू इट एंड डेफिनेटली यू ऑल आर वॉचिंग आर वीडियोज़ एंड यू ऑल आर लाइकिंग आर वीडियोज. सो डेफिनेटली इट विल बी यूजफुल फॉर यू. ओके, वी ट्राइड टू डू सो एंड डेफिनेटली वी आर गेटिंग सक्सेसफुल इन इट अकॉर्डिंग टू व्यूअर्स. सो लेट्स गो थ्रू इट. वॉट इज डेथ पेनल्टी फॉर रेप केस एंड वॉट वाई इट इज़ इन न्यूज, वॉट इज़ द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ इट, वॉट इज़ द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ इट, वॉट इज़ द क्रिटिसिज्म एंड वॉट इज़ द एडवांटेज ऑफ इट. सो वी आर गोइंग थ्रू ऑल दीज आस्पेक्ट्स, ऑल दीज टॉपिक्स. सो बी विथ मी टिल दिस वीडियो विल बी एंडेड. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो. वॉट इज़ द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ इट, वाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग दिस. सो रिसेंटली आंध्र प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट और आई कैन सी दिशा एक्ट हैज़ बीन पास्ड बाय आंध्र प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट एंड इन आंध्र प्रदेश एनेबल्स डेथ पेनल्टी फॉर रेप एंड रिड्यूसेस जजमेंट पीरियड ऑफ 21 वर्किंग डेज. सो वेन एवर द रेप हैज़ बीन डन एंड द विक्टम्स और आई कैन सी द रेपिस्ट विल बी प्रूव्ड दैट येस दीज आर द rapist or these peoples are the victims, so they will be hanged up and they will this decision will be definitely the judgment period. I can say the judgment period will be reduced by the 21 days. I mean it in just 21 working days the judicial assistance or the judicial services will give their jurisdiction or judgment within 21 days only. In these 21 days we need the proper judgment. Okay, so there is in general a widespread discussion on capital punishment involving sexual offenses against women and children. So what is the background of it? Andhra Pradesh Disha Act, this is the two new laws have been passed by the Andhra Pradesh Assembly. The first one is Special Courts for Specified Offences Act 2019 and the second one is Criminal Law Andhra Pradesh Amendment Act 2019. The new laws clubbed together as two-part Andhra Pradesh Disha Act And what is Disha case? What is Disha Act? Why we named it as Disha Act? What is Disha's case? The act has been so named as a tribute to a young Hyderabad veterinarian who was horrifyingly burnt after being gang raped. The victim was referred to as Disha, as Indian law forbids public identification of victims of sexual violence. As we all know, she was Priyanka Reddy, and this name, I mean Disha, is I can say this is the name that has been referred by the Indian for law forbids public identification of victims of sexual violence. Okay, so in Disha's case, there was exclusive evidence in CCTV videos. Accused can be seen approaching her and taking her aside. The police first turned away the victim's family when they went to complain. The police later shot the four accused when they were allegedly tried to escape the crime scene. They were there for a reconstruction of events. Okay, so it was all about this Disha's act, or all about why we are going to read this and all. Okay, so let's go through the objective of it. The new acts intend to provide tougher punishment and deliver justice to women and child victims of sexual assault by providing for quick trial and judgment. These tough legislations are intended to act as a deterrent for crimes against women and children. Special codes for specified offences Act 2019. So let's have a look of it. Specified offences against children and women Act 2019 allows exclusive special codes in each district to address crime against women and children. The state cabinet approved setting up of special courts in each of 13 districts. Okay, so what are the major changes that has been done in CRPC and IPC? What are the changes made to CRPC and IPC are in regard to Disha Act, sections 39, 173, 309, 374, 376, 376D and 377 of CRPC were amended. Sections of IPC were amended to include the death penalty as the most severe punishment for rape cases. New sections 345E, 354F and 354G were inserted in IPC, dealing with online abuse, child sexual abuse and aggravated sexual assault on children respectively. Okay, so let's take a view of analysis. I mean, let's go through the analysis of Disha's Act, Andhra Pradesh Disha Act 2019. According to it, death penalty in case of conclusive evidence that we have already discussed. And after that, increased punishment for crime against children, the crimes that are consistently increasing then against children specifically. Okay, so punishment will also be increased according to this act. Okay, punishment for online harassment, when a girl or some woman is going to harass accordingly online services, okay, like social media, emails and digital mode, something else, then the punishment will be done. Okay, so reduced period for investigation and judgment. The time period of investigation and judgment is already has been reduced, and reduced verdict period. Period allowed for disposal of appeal case has been removed to from 6 months to 3 months. Okay, the basic thing is the trial should be completed in 14 days only, and verdict has to be pronounced within 21 days. Okay, and the disposal period is also reduced. I mean, it is also reduced by 6 months to from 6 months to 3 months. Okay, the appeal period has been cut to 45 days from 6 months. It was 6 months before this act, and by this act it will be 45 days only. Okay, so special courts, these courts will take up cases of gang rape, rape and acid attacks, staking and voyeurism, sexual harassment, and cases under the protection of children from sexual offences, that is POSCO Act. Okay, so judicial officers, the state government shall nominate the judicial officers and also appoint a special public prosecutor, preferably a woman, who to conduct trials. So to conduct all these trials related to women or child sexual assaults or something like that, there will be a special woman, that will be a special public prosecutor, okay, who will conduct all these affairs. So special police team will be also be conducted. District special police teams in all the districts will be arranged by the government, and this will be headed by DSP for investigation of offences related to women and children. Women and children offenders registry, the government will establish the operate and maintain a register of women and child offenders in electronic form. This registry will be made public and will be available to law enforcement agencies. Yeah, it is important that it will be public. Okay, this will be open to each and every person. This registry will be open to each and every person and will be available to law enforcement agencies. Okay, so what is retributive justice? Retributive justice is a system of criminal justice based on the punishment of offenders rather than on rehabilitation. It is a theory of punishment that when an offender breaks the law, justice requires that he or she must suffer in return. If someone is breaking law, if someone is doing wrong that is not according to constitution or is not according to the laws or acts, then he or she have to suffer. I mean, he or she must suffer in return also. It also requires that the response to a crime must be proportioned to the committed offense. I mean, yeah, it is a person who did rape and he will get the punishment of 6 months jail or something. Yeah, no, this is not sufficient. I mean, if according to the crime, the punishment should also be done on that level, on that speech. Okay, so this was the retributive justice. Now let's go through the arguments in favor of Disha Act or death penalty. Justice delayed in, justice denied. Okay, so like in case of Nirbhaya case was brought soon after the incident of New Delhi, but today even after 7 years, the guilty in the case have been not been handled over punishment. They had never been hanged till date. Okay, so it is absolutely wrong. So justice delayed, that's why this act will be a good act for us, because we have already discussed that this time period has been reduced. I mean, it in just 21 working days judicial services have to give their judgments only. Okay, in case of delayed delivery of justice, the victim or victim's family feel that justice has been denied to them. Okay, strong deterrent. There is a dire need of laws to do amendments to create a stronger deterrence for crimes against women. Implementation of such laws should be equally efficient. Okay, it will create an environment against casual pursuance of heinous crimes against women. Okay, so governmental obligation in case of conclusive evidence. In cases where there is conclusive evidence against the accused, for example CCTV footage in case of Disha, the role of government, police and judiciary becomes even more questionable. Okay, conclusive evidence cannot just be ignored by the government. So next thing is, that is crimes against women in India. According to NCRB, it is just shocking that according to NCRB 2017 report, a total of 3.6 lakh cases of crimes against women were reported in 2017. It is not a small data. It is such a very big data. It is such a very big structure that I can say. I am shocked to see that 3.6 lakh cases against women, I mean crimes against women. So it was reported in 2017 only. This number has only increased and crimes against women are on the rise. So we'd never seen that the crimes rate or some these type of cases are getting reduced. No, consistently increasing. I mean, continuously growing up. So this ratio or data should be growing, should be grown like this. I mean, I don't think that this is a good thing for our countries. Every aspect of our country. It is not good even for our structure, for our humanity aspect, for our law aspect, everything what I can say. Okay. So India has a terrible image of being rape capital in the world. It is terrible. I got scared. I got terrified by this data. So I can say that even I'm the part of this country, the person who is outside the country or in some another country, what he or she will think if he will hurt, if he or she will hurt, like the India's per year rape cases, crime cases are 3.6 lakhs. So, bit horrifying, but we should work on it. And this act will also, act like a magical term for this data. I mean, it will be a magical way to reduce this data, to reduce. This is an effort of Andhra Pradesh governments to reduce this data. Okay. So, here we know very well that somewhere we have the positive aspect, then we definitely have to go through negative aspects also. These are here we have some criticism also against this act. So let's go through it. So it is a small window for investigation. So according to the legal experts, it is difficult for the investigation to be complete in 7 days. We reduce the days, number of days, working days. So, but here it is also a fact that in just 7 days, it will not be possible for our legal experts to investigate in just 7 days in a system where conviction rates are already poor. Okay, a time-bound investigation can worsen the things. Okay. So, yeah, here it is a fact that sometimes in just hurrying nature, or we can say we are doing a hurry up and all, then we can definitely go through some wrong decisions also. So that shouldn't be done. Okay, such a rush trial makes a mockery of both due process and idea of deliberative justice. And lack of adequate resources, we don't have such sufficient resources so that we can take the instant decisions at all. Okay, so in just short frame time, we can't go through adequate resources. We can't go through. We don't have adequate resources so that we can go through all these aspects of a crime. Okay, so legally sanctioned encounters. Some critics have referred to the act as a legally sanctioned encounters were suspected would be sentenced to death without allowing enough time to gather and assess the evidence at hand. Okay, guided by the bad reputation of the judiciary. Yeah, it is also a fact that our Indian judiciary system is also have a bad impact on public, or I can say it has a bad reputation of it. So it will definitely guide by the bad reputation of the judiciary. The next thing is guided by the public outcry. Till date, there is no law in India, force in India that authorizes the police to kill. The demand for instant kill of the accused from all corners creates a public opinion for the abandonment of the rule of law. It may lead to situation when Andhra Pradesh police shot the four accused in Disha case. Okay, extrajudicial killing, plea of self-defense by police cannot be used to rationalize a target, predetermined killing, premeditated killing of suspects in custody. And retributive justice may not be the way. It is not the ultimate way to go through. Okay, Salwa Judem case, that is 2000 in 2011, the case led a constitutional precept that no wielder of power can be allowed to claim the right to perpetuate the state's violence against anyone. When the accused are powerful, many times the police officials refrain from filling an FIR, especially when the accused are socially, politically powerful. Victims can face cross-examination about their past sexual histories. Powerful accused often attempt to quash charges or shift the trials to a friendlier city, making a mockery of fast-track cases. Tough criminal laws often target weaker sections also. Yeah, it is also a big thing that weaker sections are targeted by the tough criminal laws. And this is, according to this act, this is a toughest law, I can say. So if it will go through, then definitely it will affect the weaker section also, because they will suffer a lot of it. Okay, the most I can say the powerful sections of our society can escape themselves from so many things, and they are just successful. It is the history of our India that they got successful to do so, I mean to get escaped. But the weaker section always got in just trap of this type of issues. Okay, so this was all about the criticism against the Disha. Here it is also a criticism, some few points are here. Chances of murder increased violence. If the chance of murders are going to be increased, and the violence will also be increased here also. Okay, so reduced reporting. In the large number of rape cases, 6% of the cases in 2016, the accused is known as the victim. Given that scenario, say the accused is an uncle, having the threat of death penalty may make victim less likely to report cases. Yeah, it is a fact that sometimes they are relatives or something else, then the victims will also be like he is like my relative and all, so I can't go against that person because he will get the death penalty. Okay, so here by this the reportings will be reduced. Okay, prefer adopting non-legal ways. By going through all these things, the persons will definitely going to the victims will all definitely go through some other ways to protect themselves. Okay, so they will go through the some non-legal ways also. So the mindset which leads to crime against women can hardly be addressed with stricter laws. There is a need of ground level changes. We have to change on ground level. Justice Verma committee report acknowledged the same and recommended improving the status of women in non-legal ways. Okay, so it was all about the criticism. Now, what is the NLU report on death sentence? Recently, the fourth edition of death penalty in India annual statistics was published by Project 39A of National Law University, NLU Delhi. Okay, increased in the number of death cases relating to sexual offences. The report states that the high number of death sentences awarded in recent years related to cases of sexual offences. In 2019, it was the highest in past 4 years. There are three courts that are trial courts, high courts and supreme courts. Trial courts, then percentage of sexual offences in death cases. Death sentence cases increased from 41.35% in 2018 to 52.94% in 2019. In High Court, 65.38% of cases of confirmation of death sentence involved sexual offences along with murders. And in Supreme Court in 2019, the Supreme Court dealt with 27 capital punishment cases, the highest number since 2011. Okay, so it was the report of NLU on death sentence. Now, what is the conclusion of all these things that we had gone through the plus points, the minus points, we had gone through what it is, what this act is, and what are the NLU reports and what are the data. We have gone through all these things, but what is the conclusion of all these things? So even though the act is well intentioned, it is unlikely to meet its intended purpose and could do more harm than good. Okay, heinous crimes against women shaken the conscience of the nation, but speedy trials may not be all that is needed to resolve the issues. While it plays an important part delivering justice to the aggrieved parties, Okay, a more social culture approach may be needed to get to the root of the problem, like providing post-traumatic therapies to the aggrieved party and creating an overall women-friendly environment at homes, workplaces, judiciary, and legislature. Finally, there is no doubt that the anguish and outrage of people in the aftermath of horrific crimes is justified, but there is a need to keep in sight of the rule of law and constitutional tenets. So it was all about the death penalty that the law, Disha Act, that has been passed by the Andhra Pradesh government. We had gone through all these things, and we conclusively we can say that yeah, it is a good act and it is a good initiative, well intentioned, but possibly somewhere it can definitely harm our so many stages or platforms of our society. So in these type of cases, the hurrying nature, or we can say the nature that we go through hurriedly, and the quick decisions may harm more than this. Okay, so we should go through some ground level actions. So this was all about the death penalty. Thanks for watching. Here it was Aishi Joshi with you, and again soon I'll be here with you with a brand new session, and hope it will be useful for you. So be on time and be with me and the team of Achievers. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.